That'd be a good idea, right? Let's start streaming. Put the silver stuff down. Let us crack on with 21 to go. Now, I think I counted through the book last night and there was 19 in the book left to do. And I think two of the fates are uncovered in Chapter 8. So once we've solved all the others, then that gets revealed to us what happened to the other two. I kind of feel like one of the... I'm pretty sure one of them went down to the lazaret with the beasts. So, yeah, let's... where are we going to pick off? I want to go back to this, the cold. We'll start off with the cold tonight. So we identified these guys, right? One thing that was really, really bugging me last night. Oh, you know what? Yeah, so one thing that was bugging me last night was that I can't see that number there. That's a 46. It's definitely 46. Why didn't I zoom in on that last night? Alright, so one of these guys okay, so it's 47. It's 45, 46, so yeah, 45 to 47. Okay, so right, I want to see first off how many fates are we currently outstanding. These two. So we can do one more. We need one more, really. We need one more, like, guaranteed. I still don't know what happened to mine. So Martin was one of the people that we really don't know what happened to him. Okay, so these two are the Russians. Who else was present here? Is it just these? 22 others were present. Okay, so what I'm looking for hold on. What number was this guy? This guy here. He is 37. So who is 37? Because he's got this lady's tattoo right here. So so 37 is somebody Scottish. He's a topman. And topman. So that's higher rated seaman, special work above deck in the sails and the rigging. Right, so this guy here, right, he has a lot of tattoos. This arm here, where he would have the tattoo of the lady. All right, let's go to the end. I need to try and find out who... We need to try and find basically somebody with a tattoo. Put my heater on, but actually it's not that cold today. All right, so... Let's go. So it's going to be one of the... obviously one of the 21 we haven't found yet. So his body is this one here, right? Sure it is. Not seeing any tats though. So it's not him. Okay, I'm just gonna have to go through, like, the book, I think, at this point. Alright, so we're looking for somebody who potentially... Okay. So where does he die, actually? Oh, his disappearance. Okay, so we need to... This is on the main deck. So no, it's not him. Kind of want to go here. So he was killed by an explosion and his corpse is just there. Okay. So let's go and check out this corpse over here. This one. I think it's this one. I think it's the other one.
Let me on. That body, you bloody day. Huh? How's that?
There's no cause for trouble, boys. Get in the boat.
Before I forget, you killed my brother.
What?
That was an accident.
No probes.
It wasn't his fault. That's
all.
Nice. Oh, I shouldn't have waited so long.
No, don't.
People present. Okay, so it's not this that we want then. We want the one, the next body across, I think, is the one we need.
can't really see there. His arm's in the dark there, so we can't really see what's going on there. So let's go to the next one. Let's go across to the next one. Which I think is this guy. Looking for a tattoo is like, again, it's that arm. I can't see that arm. His arm is covered up. I would just be drawn to him as I'd be drawn to him as the guy, because just because he's got tattoos. So 37 is Lady Tat. That's what we're looking for. We are looking for Mr. Lady Tat. This guy here.
What is it?
The guy that was struck by the lightning. I want a good, okay, soldier of the sea, let's go down two and in the middle then. Okay. Really struggling for like light in like these places where I want to see people's arms and stuff. I was intrigued though. What if I change anything. I just wondered if changing it would change the light at all. No, they are though. That's Carpenter's mate. So looking at him, this guy here is an Indian top man. Or is he? I would say it's Topman, but I can't say for sure. All right, let's check out the next one then. Where's the exit? There's the exit over here. Or is
So it's this dude here, isn't it? He burns to his death. Being drawn back to this guy, but it's definitely not that guy. He's not our 37. We know who all those people are. Where else was he? This one. Unholy Captives Part 2. We're playing cards in here. Midshipmen are in here. The deduction now is just crazy. I'm running around like all these different memories trying to find a bloke with a tattoo. It's crazy.
They must have ended up in the left.
All right, so I know what this guy is because he's got like an apron on. So yeah, okay, I don't know. Topman. So he's there. Okay. Oh, man. Half an hour in on playtime and we haven't uncovered a single thing yet tonight. Find it, finally! Finally, we have found our number 37. Alright, so he's definitely him. I'm happy with that. Got 46 and 47. These two were supposedly both on. All right, so let's go and check his corpse. And we need to double check. We need to double check these ones. Oh, is that him? That's fine. So at this point, we've already lost those, so we need to... Alright, let's go to this guy then. So he was being pulled overboard, right? Got his pipe there. But yeah, he was pulled overboard here. And then we don't see him again. Where's the other guy?
Keep rowing!
I'm getting speared.
Where is it? There! Something there!
I see it!
Give us a weapon!
Shoot!
Mike and I!
Pick up the oars and row, you fools!
So he's been clawed, so maybe his fate is clawed instead. It's like they're grabbing. Alright, so who died before? That is the first one that we can see. Actually, no, we need to find this dude. I need number one.
Of course, you missed. We've reached the Canaries in 3 days. You packed our stores?
Aye, sir. Checked and loaded them myself.
Good. Stay quiet and alert. If the wind picks up, we've no chance against the Obra Dinn.
Shoot ya! We want trouble!
Obra
Dinn! 但是你的希望绝对不能让伊浪费尽的!
Shut it off.
This is strange things. We've got monsters.
I don't know if there's another. Maybe. Yes. So it should be these three that we've just found. Yeah. All right, we're at 41. We're at 41? No, we're not. We're at 42. We're at 42. 18 to go. Okay. We're off and running. That's the most important thing here. I think that's closed off murder as well now. Yep, so the first three chapters are now done. So, I now want to go to... Two pages, come on. All right, so I want to go down below. That's where we're going next. So I want to look at this guy.
Keep pressure here.
Hold him down. What madness is this? 20 years my steward, and never a doubt on your sanity. Explain yourself.
Those ungodly beasts carry a curse. Throw them back or doom us all.
Tie him up and put him in the lazarette with those things. He may yet find his senses.
Come on.
All's fine, John. Been in worse spots, I think. Where's the rest of his leg?
All right, so I think this is John, and he was by the captain's mate. Okay. So I still think this is surgeon's mate. Captain. So somebody else that's saying about throw them back or doom us all. Carpenter. He's Carpenter's mate. So they're carpenters. We know them. So he was Irish. He was the painter. We know all these people are. Somebody Scottish here. Should throw him back or doom us all. Where's the crew list? So I should probably do. I don't know, there's somebody Scottish here and I don't know where. Carpenters are American. First mate is Scottish. I've got one. Two. All right, let's try and find Let's see if we can pinpoint some of these other people now that we've got some more names and things. Oh, who was that guy? It's this guy, isn't it, that I don't know who he is. Yeah, he's the guy that kills him. This guy. Who are you? Come on, look for some more clues in here. So something isn't right. Because I've got three here. Clawed by a terrible beast. Crushed by a beast. Strangled by a beast. Just... So this guy we had. See, he was an accident though, wasn't he? This guy didn't mean to kill this guy. I mean, I could also say that he was spiked by a terrible beast, but Ultimately, he died by getting shot. Just don't know who by. Alright, we gotta look for some more clues. I think the only way we're gonna find more clues I feel like there's more to be uncovered in the bunk areas. I think I got like stripy. Okay. Gotta start putting All right, I need to go to the what's the rigging one? Right, so these are all the people that were. See, this guy has got to be a top man, surely. But fell from the rigging because he got electrocuted. So he's got like a turban on, so I would say he's Persian, but I honestly don't know. So I don't see him as... I just don't even know where to look anymore. These people are so. So where was he? Soldier of the Sea 7. Soldier of the Sea 7. Let's. It's a dude we don't know the name of, though. See, that guy just disappeared. He literally just disappeared. Alright, Soldier of the Sea again. Surely anybody on the rigging is a top man, right? So whoever that was sounded French. No, it's not this guy. So this guy is the only French, this is the only French person we have left. Nothing is said in that one. That's the problem. Could be him. It could even be that guy. I mean, doesn't really look very English, if I'm honest. mean, it's crazy. We're just trying to literally brute force things now. Where's the captain steward? It's him, isn't it? All right, so hold on, let's go back. Alright, so he disappears in the Doom Part 8. Now, I originally thought that these markers showed where they were, but it doesn't, does it? The markers show which memories they were on, so... The reason I went for that is because somebody down here... ...was shouting orders. Thank you. But I don't know. Alright, so I want to look for any... Should know who that is. All right, so right, he's in here. Okay, so let's go back to a bit of cold. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through the bunks. I'm going to write down all the bunk numbers because. I feel like that's a way to deduce who and who I have and who I haven't seen. It's got 54. So, 51, 54, 53. Who is this guy? So he's 52. Okay. So then we have 58, 57. We've done these ones. 55 and 56. Seven, 45, 46. Forty-one, forty, 39, 46, 37, 42. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. It's 19 bunks. Now... So So there's still three people then that I've not accounted for. Alright, but anyway. The idea behind this is I can cross people off, so... So, remaining is 58, 57, 55, 47 solved, 45 is solved, 46 is solved, 59... 38, 41, 39, 40, 36. 37 is solved, 42. Right, so that leaves me with 10 possible names. Alright, so now I want to go back to here. So, where is he? John. Okay, so I would like to think that is John. But I can't say for sure. All right, so that's that. Let's go back to the crew. I can't make any assumptions for these two. Those two people that I think are going to be revealed in Chapter 8. Alright, so my choices here, I think, are 39, 38... 39, 40, 41, 42, 36, 58, 59, 57, 55. He's in Soldiers of the Sea. But is he up or is he down? Does it really matter? Man. She was hoping to find some people that were killed by people on the ship. But so all the people here are seamen, I believe. So these two, I would assume, are seamen too. I've never really used the bookmark thing. Right, who else is there? Who else was there? I'm guessing I haven't got this John down right. So let's go back to the cargo deck.
Keep pressure here.
What madness is this?
See, he's got to be a steward the way he's dressed. See, I think he's talking to somebody else called John. Talking to it's just he's so I can't imagine he would be John because he's in the surgeon's place. So, I think I'm going to have to So, I'm just going to do a quick Google thing. Swedish. All right, so Swedish. So yeah, I've got him right. He is definitely him. Really struggling though now. Really struggling. So, there is a what's called the hint or nudge guide. I'm just looking at it at the minute on my machine. So basically, it's a way that it will guide you, but it doesn't spoil anything. So this guy will try and point you to places you've missed while still letting you solve the mystery yourself. So, introduction. This is a hint guide for Obra Dinn. It doesn't contain the full fates of each crew member, but it will
give you oblique pointers for places to examine more closely. After all, a lot of the fun in mystery games is figure it out for yourself, and there's a lot of voids to examine. I've been explicit with the causes of death and locations of corpses that gate the game's chapters, because that what mystery that's there is usually unintentional. So, non-specific advice. So what assumptions can you safely make? The ship's manifest is completely accurate in every detail, and no one changed names or status during the voyage. Crew members stick to what they're best at doing during typical conditions. Officers don't help with the rigging. Seamen don't spend time in the officers' quarters unless they have permission. Officers and stewards tend to stick together during unusual circumstances. There are a few of those crew members tend to help where needed. Crew members only ever speak in their own language and English. Formosan and Chinese are similar enough that Chinese crewmen can understand the Formosans. In some cases, Chinese crew members will translate for Formosan passengers. There is a way to identify every crew member without relying on stereotype. Sorry. And you will not be able to find definite proof of every crew member's identity. You'll have to make informed guesses at times. But that's not been paying dividends for us, let's face it. So, what should I know about determining cause of death? As an insurance inspector, accident is not an acceptable cause of death. Be tediously specific. Stabbed is also not an acceptable cause of death. You must specify the weapon. And ambiguous deaths will often accept multiple answers as long as the culprit is accurate. All right, so we are on am I looking for? Soldier of the Sea? Nope. All right, so unholy captives. You'll need to use a process elimination to identify this man. The weapon is present in the scene. Yep. Sword. You can definitely identify this man from this scene alone. Check the crew logs and think about what the dialogue means. Yes, the guy did him. So a person is named during this scene, but it won't be clear at first who this refers to. So that would lead me to believe that this isn't necessarily John. So I'm starting to think that guy something he's John, but I really don't know. See, the first memory is
So we've only got two at the minute anyway. Alright, so let's look at the calling. Part two. Alright, so there's a lot of confusion going on here. Try and work out the nationalities of the seaman, and this man's identity should become clear. Alright, I need to listen to this. Okay, let's get out of here. So he was speared, right?
Stay quiet and alert. The wind picks up, we've no chance against the Obra Dinn.
Shoot ya! The one trouble!
That's
here, I'm going to turn him! It's up to my kid eye!
I shut it up!
This is strange things! About monsters!
This guy, that guy. I've missed his death. Listen carefully.
Keep rowing!
Where is it?
There! Something there!
I see it!
Here's a weapon!
Shoot it!
My kid eye!
Pick up the oars and row, you fools!
Kind of want to listen to that again. Samuel Galligan. Is he Irish? Yeah. Right, so what does this dude actually say? Also, it can't be John because John's alive later on. So that would make it one of these two, right? So he's the one that says, give us a weapon. Sound. All right, what else have we got? Unholy captives. So we've done him. Second bloke. This man cannot be definitively identified. You'll need to identify more of the crew before this. There's only one person this could be. So I think this is one of the Chinese topmen. But okay. We're not sure about this guy. All right, soldiers of the sea. Identifying this man is difficult. You should be able to narrow this man down to his nationality. Once you've identified the other two crewmen of his nationality who are still alive,
Will you be able to identify this man? Chapter 2, look for ways to link crew of this nationality with their possessions. The other person who appears to be wearing the same item in this scene can be identified in Chapter 7. The other two clearly don't wear the same item. So what was chapter 2? So I wonder if I missed something there. Been a very slow freaking episode today, guys. I do apologize.
Enter here. One swing. Get true to skull in stone or brain. I'll cut her throat when you've done it.
Here?
Come on before she kicks up. You all right there, sir?
Yeah, this guy has got to be the surgeon's mate. I'm not going to butch on that anymore.
Never been on a farm, John.
Mind your shoes now.
He's in here cleaning up in the surgeon's room after they've moved this guy, alright? There's nothing to tell here. There's nothing to do here. So, right, so which crew members then are the Indian? What numbers are they? Sorry, Chinese are 38 to 41. Alright. So yeah, this scene is still vitally important. It seems.
Sayed, don't talk. Good feel.
Thank you.
Right, so something here. I don't know about everybody out of you guys, but it kind of looks to me like this one guy has got like white top shoes. All right, so they're all Topman. 39 has white shoes. Okay. Now I want to go to Soldiers of the Sea, which is back up here. Okay, so this guy is, what did I just write that? I wrote something down, I don't even know, the 38. Okay. So, top man. I'm gonna put all these down as topmen because they're all on the rigging, right? So I just think that would make sense because I don't see why anybody else other than a topman would be on the rigging here. Identity. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Is that all the top men we have? Seven top men? Seven. So who was that in number two? Hold on. So how many have I actually got now? Two. I don't know why I changed that. He was definitely electrocuted. But kind of got like an open toe shoe on. All right, well. What's going on, Elfwin? I'm really struggling at the minute. I'm at like 42. And I'm really struggling now to kind of piece together the last bits of information. So why's my camera gone black? What's going on with my camera? Weird. Sorry, guys. There we go. Much better. Yeah, it's... I don't want, like, stone-cold gimmies, but I found a kind of, like, a... It's not really a guide. It's more of a... Like a nudging guide to try and nudge you in the right direction for some people. So let me go back down to... Let me go back down to... I want to go back to the cold. This particular scene seems to... It seems to be so pivotal. So... We know all those guys. We just worked him out. Although we haven't validated him yet. Here. So. 38. For now. I am going to say. This guy is 38. What? That guy's 38. Oh, geez. I need to go back. Because he's got the open toe shoes on. This guy has white shoes. So I got the white shoe guy wrong. Did I? Yeah, I must have done. All right, back we go. That guy. I totally wrote it wrong down. I wrote the wrong freaking number down. No wonder. Jeez. All right, so let's get back to the cold. Okay. So I got that he was strangled, but I don't know if he was strangled or if he was, I think he was clawed, was he? The beast has got the thing around his neck, so it kind of feels like he was strangled by the beast. Both of these people were, but now both, the problem is though, something is wrong, because I'm sure I've got three now. See, I've got that,
and those two. Okay, so maybe I've got the cause of death wrong. You're suggesting I go and take a look at the cause of death. Right, so that's 39. Soldiers of the Sea is on the all-up deck in the middle. Gotcha. Oh. Elfwyn, thank you very much for that little tidbit. Whew. We're at 45. Okay. Who we got left? Go back to our list. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 possible topmen left. 2 Chinese. So we've got 2 of the Chinese left, which are 40 and 41. So let me go see if I can take another look at the cold again. It's this way. If there's anything else at all I can take from 41 and 42 to differentiate them.
Sayed? Sayed Uto? Good feel.
Hold on, 38. So I'm looking at 40 and 41. Alright, it's these two here. I can't really tell anything about him. Yeah, I'm getting nothing from that. I've been trying. I have been trying to go through the scenes to try and find them, and I can't find it. So that's why I'm always coming back to this one. I did think at another point there would be kind of like something else. So all right. So let me. If that's the case. Because they're on the gun deck, right? Now, I think I checked. I'm pretty sure I checked. Sorry, I can't get my words out. I'm pretty sure I checked, like, in the big gun thing, in the big, when the cannons or everything are going off. Could be a possibility there. Not going to be here, because that's all off the ship. Pretty sure I went through chapter 6 as well. I didn't find anything in chapter 6. So the Doom is where all the cannons and everything are going off. Let's head to chapter 9. Let's see what. If we can uncover anything in chapter 9. Where is my Frenchman? And the audio says, squid's gone, your mate was torn apart. So, to me, that would... That would suggest to me that the bloke that got torn apart was the guy with the tattoos is the one that got torn apart. This guy. So I would say that is that. He was there when he got ripped apart, was he? Okay. So that would mean then, I'll put him back as a top man then for now. Let's go to the... Let's go back to so he got torn apart. It's gone. Your mate was torn apart. All right, so where was he then right before this? It's chapter 7. No, it's fine. It's fine. All right, so let's look the Doom Part 7. See, that's a guy that got ripped apart. That guy doesn't look so much like he got ripped apart. Alright, so, yeah, this is the guy that got ripped apart. This guy, this is another guy that's really peeing me off, because I know he's, I've got him down for something, for a killing of somebody, but because I can't work out or don't know what his name is at the minute. So where is this guy? Is this... is that my guy I'm looking for? No. Alright, this is the guy I'm looking for. So yeah, I mean, it kind of looks like he's going to then... Yeah, he would have seen that. Okay. That's fair enough. So, where is...
So Abigail is literally the only one in. She's only in that one scene. So let's go to look at her scene then on the Doom 8. So that's him getting his arm ripped off. So he disappears in the Doom. Right, so he disappears here. He definitely doesn't fall from the rigging. So that's the tattoo guy. I know he's not dead because he's in the end bit. So, that leads me to think that this guy is the mate. The helmsman, and there's nobody else, is there? So we can see everybody else. That's Paul. That's the two women who escaped. He disappears here too. But if I'm honest, it doesn't look like he's getting torn apart. But then it doesn't look like he is either. What I mean. I kind of feel like I want to say this is the French guy. But I can't say what the cause of death is. That's the only issue. Definitely didn't fall from the rigging, though. I There's some more hints in the last chapter of Unholy Captives and the first two chapters of Soldiers on the Sea. Okay. So let's go and have a look at Unholy Captives first. Okay, so it's this one.
Keep pressure here.
Hold him down. What madness is this? 20 years my steward, and never a doubt on your sanity. Explain yourself.
Those ungodly beasts carry a curse. Throw them back, or doom us all.
Tie him up, and put him in the lazarette with those things. He may yet find his senses.
Come on.
All's fine, John. Been in worse spots, I think. Where's the rest of his leg?
So I don't know who the surgeon's talking to there either. I initially thought this guy here was John, but I'm not so sure. Now, that guy is here. See, Bonson is... The bosun's there as well. Tied him up. Okay, so that is thinking about the right sort of lines on this. The other one you said was the first two chapters of Soldier Under the Sea. He's tied him up with... okay. First two chapters of Soldiers on the Sea. Now, I think I'm probably going to look at chapter 2. Let's look at chapter 2. Is he a seaman? You see, all these guys are seamen, I think. See, that's what throws me, though. If all of these guys are potentially seamen... See, that would then... This is what's throwing me. I would then say this guy is a seaman, because if everybody else is... Take a look at chapter one. Do you mean like actual chapter one or part one of this chapter? See, all these guys are, I believe, a topman. But what are these doing down here? Okay, so he's there. Alright, so he's there. I need to listen to the audio again. I need to listen to the audio. Yeah. Alright, it is. That's confirmed it for me. He's there. I was looking around before to try and pick out, and I don't know why I didn't see it before. I was looking around at these people to try and work out who was there, but yeah, he's at the front. As the things kind of collapsed or the rope's been pulled, he's then stood there while everybody else is scattered. All right. That helps me, though. That does help me, because... Right. We're going to mark this guy... This guy. As him. Now, I know... That... This guy was shot by him. It was an accident, but he was shot by him. Alright, so, the only question then now is, how did he die? Disappeared. Well, I'm not going to be able to. I'm not going to be able to. I won't be able to gauge any of it because. So I've got five seamen left, right? Let me go back to. Sorry, I'm chopping and changing a lot. One, two. There's only two seamen there. Right, but the seamen are numbered from... So, alright, let me turn this over. Right, so I've got seamen are 50, 55, 57, 58, and 59. Topman are 36, 40, 41, 42, 43, and 44. Okay, so... John Naples is number 50. So I want to go back to a bit of coal in a minute. And I want to see if I can take a look at bunk 50 to get any sorts of clues as to what he was wearing, what he looks like.
Sayed? Sayed Ruto? Good feel.
I guess I need to, I don't know, I've got to find some other numbers. 55. Kind of looks like a bit of a lighter shoe, but I mean, I really need to find where kind of deduction range does John have. That's a good question. See, I just thought this was John originally. Yeah, you have to go to the actual picture, so... So it's the surgeon
talking to somebody called John in this scene. And we know it's not the... We know... It's not the fourth mate. He's already been accounted for. I don't think he's in this scene, is he? No, the fourth mate is not in this scene. So, seaman-wise... One there... Then we have these ones here, though, as well. So John has got to be one of these three. Now, initially, I had John down as this guy. Because the surgeon says, all's fine, John. Been in worse spots, I think. Where's the rest of his leg? I'm sure it's the surgeon. Yeah, so, that's the surgeon's mate. That, I think, is the ship's steward. Been in worse spots. All's fine, John. Been in worse spots. I just think he's talking to him. I'm telling him everything will be okay. You've been in a worse situation. So the other guys, carpenters, those are the carpenters. That is one of the Indian guys. He's one of the officers. Yeah, so the other seamen are up here. So... Why on... The surgeon wouldn't be talking to somebody two decks up. So I'm going to go back to my original deduction that this is John. And the way the doctor's saying it is he's saying, it's all right, John, you've been in worse spots. But then he's asking somebody where his leg is. So that's two. And I still think this guy is the Persian. Yes! I had him down as a Persian earlier on because of his headwear. Mm-hmm. All right.
That leaves me with 12. Did I see him fall? The Persian guy. No, but last night I traced him back. I'm sure last night I was tracing him back. What's going on, Adam Place? How you doing, buddy? So yeah, what I was doing last night was I was going through kind of here. It was on part 6 of the Doom. Right, so yeah. Let's go to part 6. I'm pretty sure I saw him. Right, so basically the story of this is the ship, we're based in 1807, the ship Obra Dinn set out on a voyage, and it never met its destination. And then randomly, a few years later, it turns up, all the crew are dead, and we get sent on board to try and deduce everything that happened. The Borealis. Most definitely not the Borealis. All right, so I saw him there. That's him. I'm sure it is. Yeah. So that's where I saw him, and I was looking around here and I saw him falling over there. So that's why I put him down as fell off the rigging. Elfin. Nothing to do with the Borealis, my man. Nothing at all. Okay, so I think it's a really cool art style. It's meant to be slightly obscured, though, so that it's not so easy to see people. All right, so I still don't know what happened to this guy. Well, that's definitely him, though. Oh, no. Yeah, sorry. I do have... Of course I do. He was torn apart. Of course. Because they say in the chapter 9, when he's talking, he says, your mate was torn apart. Of course, yeah. Of course. Alright, so we know what's happened to him. He's done. No, there is, because he's the bosun's mate, right? And just to explain to Adam, when the bosun, in his bit here, he does say, where is my Frenchman? And then the reply is, the squid's gone, your mate was torn apart. So, you should see some of the things in this game, Adam, seriously. One of us... Okay, so I need to find this scene. So I have a feeling it's going to be part of the escape. So let's go up to the top here.
Do you know what I've just realised? Just realised as well. I just realised that the pocket watch points. The pocket watch points to the chapter. Man. Oh, it's not this. It's not this one. So I need to get down to the Orlop deck. Alright, it's not escape. This all happens off the ship. Oh, Soldiers of the Sea, of course. So, we're here because we are working for an insurance claims company. The East Indian Company have been sent here as an insurance investigator. And we're trying to basically piece everything together to understand what went on. Not this place. Well, the ship's drifted into port, so we're not sort of like in the middle of nowhere, Adam. Far from it. All right, so we're not down far enough, though, are we? I'm on the wrong deck. Well, yeah, we are in a certain point, Adam.
Where are you?
I'm sure I looked at all this before. Let's go on, Deathwish.
struggling to find. Am I in the right place? No, why am I down here? I don't want to be down here. Jeez. I was in the right place before it. Yeah. They were all sleeping in here amongst the cannons. Why on earth do I think it was down? I don't know. It's got to a point now where everything is really tricky. Everything's tricky, and it's just like finding information now is getting really, really difficult. And I don't know, I'm not frustrated with the game, I'm just... I just want things on the gun deck. I tell you what threw me is because I went to a cold, and I've been doing this all the way through. I went to the bitter cold, and the corpse is on the all-up deck, but he actually dies on the gun deck. Right, so... we're looking for things that happened on the gun deck. Yeah, I think you just get to a point where you start to get... let's check this out. I'm just getting to a point where the information is few and far between now. And the people that you have left, there is really little information. You have to be really, really observant to pick up on the information. What I was looking for. See, I'm drawn back to here, but I don't think I could get down below, could I? No. See, I can't get down below. Everything's closed off.
official radio unit.
Hey, come on, boss. No, get there.
Yeah, you see, nobody here is. Nobody's asleep there, which is the thing. Transcript in part 3 of Soldiers might yield some clues. Okay. Stay right next to already. Well, Nick is the, I think Nick is the name of the carpenter's, oh no, okay. Aha, so. There is a top man here. It goes by the name of Nick. I've already identified everybody in this scene, though. There's somebody else being spoken to. The way I read that though is somebody's being told to stay away because it's the beast is already dead effectively. So then but if that's the case, then that would possibly mean that's Nick. I just kind of feel that though, if that was done for, Nick.
What's going on?
Stay back. It's already over, Nick.
Hey, Come on, boss. No, get there. Hey, cat!
I guess it's interpretation of the dialogue, but yeah, like I say, I would have interpreted that as somebody telling Nick the beast is already done for. All right, well. I'm across 42 off my list of Tottenham. I really want to try and get three more done. So that's two. Okay, so if I can get one more, we can obviously do some checking. Night of the Kraken attack. So that is this, isn't it? No, it's not this one. It's the Doom. So let's go. I'll look at this Kraken's bits and pieces then. So I don't think there's anybody else in this part of the scene, is there? No. And other than that seaman, we know everybody else. Okay. So let's move on to the next scene. Which is the painter. Okay.
43 and 44. So they're the two Chinese people. They look like they're wearing the same thing, so I can't deduce anything from them. 45, we already know the identity of. We don't need to know. 1441, sorry. So, okay. That would suggest to me that that's him. Can't tell on that because his hammock's fallen down. Doing. But if that's right, then I've got some things wrong because if this is him, his cause of death is wrong, I think. So he disappears in the doom. Right, part 8 of the doom. Let's go check part 8 of the doom again. The cause of death has got to be wrong because I am 99% sure that the other two are right. Okay, so that's him. He's not falling. Crushed?
What's the other two guys missing? So yeah, the other two guys I've got are the bosun's mate who is torn apart and all right, let's check this guy. Right, unless he's not been speared, this other guy is not being speared. But he looked pretty speared to me. Well, all right. So how many have we got left? Now, Martin, I am pretty sure Martin and Philippe will be uncovered in chapter 8. Because he gets taken to the lazarette, we don't know what happens to him, and there's no option here to set anything for what happened to him. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 more to find. We have 7 more to find. That ain't gonna happen, Deathwish. All right, but I'm gonna be wrapping things up there because it's late. And I've actually played this for a lot longer than I was intending to play it for tonight. I was only going to play for about an hour and a half to 2 hours, but I'm glad we kind of stuck on for a little bit longer than what I was originally going to. So we started off with 39 tonight. We are up to 51, so 12 solved. It was pretty slow going for a lot of like the early game, but I kind of want to say thank you to Elfwin. I did have kind of like a nudging thing up that I was trying to work through, but no, you've kind of pointed me in the right direction now. So yeah, 7 more to find. Like I said, I think those two that I said before will be all uncovered in chapter 8. So find the 7 and then we'll see what else happens. So fingers crossed, one more stream and we should be all the way through. But guys, thank you very much everybody for tuning in and watching tonight. I appreciate the support. As always, nothing works because why would it work? Why would anything work? Links are on screen, guys. If you haven't done already, please go and check them out. I gratefully appreciate it. We'll be back on Monday night in our attempt to put this to bed. But until then, I've been Nock. You've been awesome. See ya.